My name is Sean Krikorian. I'm the festival coordinator for Pigeon Key Art Festival. The Pigeon Key Art Festival has been going on for about 22 years. It's once a year, the first weekend in February. People will see 72 or 73 different artists here. We have photographers, jewelers, fiber artists, pottery, ceramics, graphics, just about any fine art you could possibly imagine is here. The artist Wyland is here doing two shows a day, and then he auctions off the paintings he does to help support the Pigeon Key Foundation and their fundraising goals. So when he does those paintings, he'll auction them for about $2,500 a piece. Those paintings are usually worth between $8,000 and $12,000, and it's a way for attendees to support the event and also get an incredibly collectible piece of artwork. We brought some community partners in to really enhance the festival feel. So Pigeon Key itself has a lot of marine educational programs. They work with kids from all over the country, marine camps, and they also work very closely with our marine education partners here in town. So Dolphin Research Center was an obvious choice, as was Turtle Hospital and Save a Turtle and Aquarium Encounters and all those folks that have something to do with the marine environment and ecology and everything here. So it just seemed like a great fit to bring those groups together in one place and give them a stage as part of the whole event. Because it's been advertised as a festival, we wanted to make this show have a lot of elements that would bring a lot of people or attract a lot of people to it. So in addition to the community partners, we brought in historical aspects and we brought in some local artists or display pieces to give people things to look at. We have some groups doing presentations on the stage like Florida Keys Community College and the Turtle Hospital. Historical reenactors have taken some time to present the Flagler's whole history and some of the history of the shipwreckers here.
My name is Mindy Tucker. I work for the Key West Shipwreck Treasures Museum. You can also call me Lillian Taylor. We're here representing Shipwreck Treasures Museum with Historic Tours of America. We became affiliated because they wanted to start making this festival more of a heritage festival, and they wanted to bring in some of the history. And what better history than the shipwrecking history that has to deal with Key West?
The Pigeon Key Foundation board members really take an active role in ensuring that this festival is a success, from going out and soliciting donors to giving their time to make sure everything happens the way it's supposed to happen. This event couldn't be the success it is without the volunteers that donate their time. We have over 160 volunteers that give up time on their Saturdays and Sundays to come here and make this event a successful part of the community. So we really like to thank all of them. I've been talking to some of the guests as they leave, and the feedback we've been getting has been really positive. The festival is very impressive for them. They have a lot of things to see and do today. A lot of people said they want to come back because they don't think they were able to see everything that happened. So that's great news for us. We're really happy that people are happy about the event today.